Hi students, hope you all go through the SQL tutorials already given. So today we are going to study constraints and the constraint. How will you insert a constraint when you are creating a table or a schema? And also, what will be constraint violation? So there are already we have studied in module 2 what is a constraint. Constraint means you are giving some restrictions or limitations to the data. So there are different types of constraints, semantic and syntactic constraints are there. Hope you all remember it. So let's see. There are different types of constraints. So how will you insert those constraints in SQL commands? Definitely for creating a table or altering a table, how will you create or input some constraints? So we can see that first one is not null constraint. That means you can restrict some attributes to be not null, the value. So you have to put some value for that. You can't let it null value. And next is unique. That means the value and date should be unique in a particular attribute. And next, all of you aware about it, primary key. And next is foreign key. And finally, check constraint. So data constraints. Data constraints means the rules which are enforced on data being entered and prevents the user from entering invalid data into the tables. That is, we have already discussed. So let's see input on output constraint. Further divided into two, primary key constraint and foreign key constraint. In addition to primary key and foreign key constraint, Oracle has not null and unique column constraint also. So before that, we can see how will you input that constraint. So we can define that constraints in two levels. One is the column level and other one is table level. What do you mean by column level constraint? That means if data constraints are defined along with the column definition when creating or altering a table structure, they are column level constraints. When you are creating a table with an attribute name, its data type, then you can give the constraint along with the column definition. Likewise, column level constraint. That means column level constraints are applied to the current column only. So we can a column level constraint cannot be applied if the data constraint spans across multiple columns in a table. That means if you are defining it in column level constraint and the same constraint is for the same constraint is giving for two attributes, you have to specify it separately for those two constraint attributes. Okay, then what do you mean by table level constraint? Table level constraint means if data constraints are defined after defining all the table columns. For example, if your data constraint spans across multiple columns in a table, then table level constraint can be applied. That is the table level constraint. So let's see the different types of constraints. You all know the null value concept. Null values are clubbed at the top of the column. Okay, it is different from a blank or a zero. Oracle allows null values. Okay, if data is unknown or some data is missing or currently that not data is not available there, you can put a null value there. So next is not null constraint. This is the first constraint. Not null constraint means when a column is defined as not null, then that column becomes a mandatory column. You cannot leave it as null value or blank. Okay. So when you are creating a table, at the creation of the table, create table, table name, the column name, its data type, size, and space, then not null. This is a constraint for this particular column only. That means this column is having a value. It cannot be left null. For example, create a table EMP with following mandatory fields: EMP number, name, job, salary, and department number. So you will create like this: create table EMP. EMP, EMP number means that is a particular column, number is the data type, and 4 is the size. And you have inserted a constraint here, that is a not null constraint. Okay, at the definition of this table itself, that means when you are entering the values to this particular column, EMP number, you cannot left it null, it should have a value. Hope you all understand it. Then you will get a response like table created. And next is unique constraint. Unique constraint means the purpose of unique is to ensure that information in the column is unique. That means no two values should be same. So for that, same column name, data type, size, unique. Okay, so when you are creating the table, create table, table name, the particular column name, and data type. The difference is when you are defining the constraint unique means it permits multiple entries on the null value into the column. That means if you are giving a constraint unique means it should have some multiple null values. Okay. And if you are giving not null constraint, it should have more, similar values in that particular column, but it should not be left null. For example, the difference is in the primary key constraint. Primary key constraint means it is one or more columns in a table used to uniquely identify each row in the table. That means both the constraint not null and unique can be applied in this primary key. If you are giving it as not null constraint, the value cannot be a null value. Values can be repeated. And if you are giving unique constraint, it should have null values, but the values cannot be repeated. Duplicate values cannot be there, but multiple null values can be there. But if you are giving primary key constraint, both these constraints are applied here. It should be not null and unique, so that you can identify a particular row. Okay, here you are applying. How will you insert this primary key constraint? It can be defined at the column level or in table. Column level means column name, data type, size, space, primary key. That means this column should not be a null value, or it cannot hold similar values in the attribute. Okay, no duplicates and no null values are allowed in this column. And if you want to create this primary key for more than one attribute, you can define it in table level. For example, you are defining create table, table name, your all columns are defined here along with the data type and size. And after that, you can give primary key. Okay, primary key inside the bracket, the column names. Okay, column name, which all columns in EMP number, EMP name, likewise you can define those columns which all attributes are having primary key constraint. That means if you are defining it in table level, table level is applicable for multiple, this constraint is spanned for multiple attributes. But if you are Giving this constraint for a single attribute, you can define it in column level. Hope you understand it. And then foreign key constraint. What is a foreign key? Foreign key constraints represents a relationship between the tables. A foreign key is a column whose values are derived from the primary key or unique key of some other table. Okay, that means it is referenced by another table. The table in which the foreign key is defined is called a foreign table or detail table. And the table that defines a primary key or unique key and it is referenced by the foreign key is called the primary table or the master table. So from the master table you are referring this foreign key. Okay, the table which is using that foreign key is known as the foreign table or detail table. The relationship is ensure some rules are there. Records cannot be inserted into a detail table if corresponding records in the master table do not exist. That means you can enter only values in this detail table if that value exists in the master table. Similarly, records of the master table cannot be deleted if corresponding records in the detail table exist. That means master table is the table which is having a primary key or a unique key and you are referring those details from the master table. That is in the detail table. So you cannot delete a particular row which is used by the detail table. Okay, so that is constraint violation. The existence of a foreign key implies that the table with the foreign key is related to the master table from which the foreign key is derived. It can also be defined in two levels, either in column level or at table level. If you are defining it for a particular column, you can define create table, table name, syntax is the column name, data type, size, then references. References is the keyword used here. References which table? Okay, suppose if you are having two tables, employee and a dependent table, and you are referring some details from employee table and you are creating a dependent table here. Okay, then create table dependent the employee number which references from where? From the master table. So that table should be, that master table should, table name should be given here. That is the employee table name. Then the corresponding column name in the employee table, maybe EMB number. Okay, likewise. Similarly for table level, if it is table level, you can define all the columns there. Create table, table name, your column number 1, 2, 3, all, and then put a comma, and after that, foreign key. Okay, foreign key, column name. Okay, which column? Okay, column name is the keyword here. So, which column name? Okay, references, table name of which attribute in that master table. Okay, so this is the key constraints of how will you insert or define certain. Okay, thank you. Go through this and practice it online and inform me. Thank you.